jump.
Well, welcome back to the Israel issue, where we're presently thinking about what issues out of those gifts that God placed into the roots of Israel and what that means for those of us who are grafted into Israel. And today we're thinking about God's gifts of his covenants, which he placed in the roots of Israel. Now, this comes in the third place in that gifts list that Paul set out at the start of Romans chapter 9 in verse 4, where he spoke about how God had first given to Israel the gift of being adopted as sons. And then secondly, the encounters which he'd given them with his glory. We've thought about these two in the previous two episodes, and we've seen how Yeshua redeemed these gifts from what they become in the hands of Israel, then giving them back to Jewish believers so that they could then fulfill their calling, and also to we who are grafted in Gentiles, enabling us to live as heirs of the riches of God's character, and also to be changed from glory into glory, even in our everyday lives. And today we're going to see how this also worked out with the gift of the covenants which God gave to Israel. So let's begin by thinking about that first covenant that God made, which was with Abraham, and that it was unconditional, it was irrevocable, and very specifically, as Genesis 12 verse 3 says, it was so that through Israel, blessing would come upon all the families of the earth. And then let's also remind ourselves about the new covenant, which God only ever promised to the houses of Israel and Judah. Because we read in Jeremiah 31, "Behold, days are coming when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. I will put my Torah, my law, within them. Yes, I will write it on their heart. I will be their God and they will be my people." So God's purpose in promising the new covenant to Israel was to enable his relationship with the people of Israel to be restored. As he later said through the prophet Hosea, "Like a vulture, he comes against the house of the Lord, for they have overstepped my covenant and transgressed my Torah, my law." God so wanted the people of Israel to have his Torah in their hearts, etched on their hearts, not only out there somewhere around them, but right there in them, shaping them in the way they thought and the way they lived, so that he could have restored heart-to-heart relationship with his people. Because God's covenant is all about reciprocated faithfulness. And this was the context of the words that Yeshua said at the Passover meal when he took the third cup, the cup of redemption, and he said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you." And so much hung on those three little words, new, my, and you. Because even though the new covenant was nothing like the covenant that God made with Moses, it still didn't mean that the old had been completely done away with. New simply spoke about the renewing or the restoring of that reciprocated covenant relationship between God and his people. And my spoke about the part that only Yeshua as the Jewish Messiah could play to make that possible in any way. And then you spoke about the people to whom it was promised directly, the people of Israel that the disciples, as they sat around in that Passover meal, represented. The people to whom it was directly promised so that they might become the people that God had originally called them to be and then to do what he had called them to do. And when we see the context of the new covenant like this, then we realize how incredibly crucial and vitally important it is that we understand that we who are Gentiles are only grafted into this. Indeed, that's why Paul wrote so emphatically to the Gentile believers in Ephesus to say that they should never, ever, ever forget that once they were separate from Messiah, excluded from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers to the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. Now, if we don't have this as the starting point of our understanding of our relationship with the God of Israel, we'll never really understand what that relationship is really based in and what it is really for. And like anything that we have in life that we don't quite understand how it really works, we will then never get the best out of it. And that, of course, is the problem with so much of today's church, which, whether or not it knows it, is into replacement theology, thinking that it has replaced Israel in God's purpose, having no real understanding of what it actually means to be grafted into Israel. And without that understanding of being grafted in, effectively, it is then wired up wrongly to God. But if we do have the understanding of being grafted into Israel, then we can properly understand the sap which we can draw up from the roots of Israel into which God has gifted covenant relationship. And we understand that it should then bring forth the fruitfulness that God intended it to bring out in Israel, because it's the very same sap. And as it brings into Israel the fruitfulness of restored covenant relationship, enabling Israel to be the people God called Israel to be and to do the things that God called Israel to be doing. So this is what it should be producing in our own lives. It should be producing a picture of covenant relationship with God that shines like light in the midst of a dark world. And when we understand that, we see how it shifts the focus of the new covenant away from being primarily upon our personal salvation, important as that is in the new covenant, but it takes the focus away from that to the greater purpose that God has actually brought us into covenant relationship with him for, which is put so well in Hebrews 13, which says this: "Now, may the God of peace, the God of Shalom, who brought up from the dead the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of an everlasting covenant, our Lord Yeshua, make you complete in every good thing to do his will." Now, isn't that the most exciting and amazing of prospects? That the more we engage with the new covenant to help us understand the everlasting covenant that God gave to Israel, the more we will be enabled to complete that particular purpose and calling that God has for our individual lives, wherever he has placed us, that we may shine like lights in a dark place, that we might point others to him as the one true God, the God of Israel. Isn't that the most amazing prospect? If you'd like to think more about this, then do go to our website, www.lettheLionRoar.com. Go to the Israel Issue tab, and there you'll find a short study to go with today's episode. You'll also find previous episodes you might like to refer back to. If you're watching for the first time, do hit that subscribe button so that you'll get it direct in the future. And do tell others about this most crucial, vital, and important of issues. And I look forward to being back with you in the near future with another episode of the Israel Issue.